Shalom. Start by saying all praises to Yahweh. Barsham, Yahweh Shai, Barsham, Arakar Kadash. Double honors unto the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, who rule well. And Shalom to the whole four elect. Correct? So. Right, I'm a Hebrew Israelite. I come out every week to prophesy the downfall of this kingdom, which is known as Babylon the Great, starting with America. Alright. Trying to find one scripture, but it's escaping me right now. But basically we're in the last days, right? And that's why we're in the midst of a pandemic. Right? These are all things that I prophesied of in the Bible. It's a lucky amount. Right, so this is the book of Habakkuk, the second chapter and the first verse. It reads, I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower and will watch to see what he will say unto me when I shall answer when I am reproved. Right, so basically this is Habakkuk back in his time, basically speaking of the fact that he was prophesying in his time, right, of things to happen. Right, and that's the same thing that I'm speaking of right now. So it says, and the Lord Yahweh answered and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables, that he may run and read of it. So back then what you had is you had the tables in which you had scribes writing upon them, right? So tablets and whatnot, tablets of stone that the words were written upon. And that's what Habakkuk basically was instructed to do, the same thing. And all the prophets inside of the Bible, that's what they were instructed to do. Right? So let me read that part again. It says, and the Lord Yahweh answered me and said, write the vision, alright, because the Heavenly Father basically showed a vision unto Habakkuk. Like all the prophets in the Bible, they had a vision that was shown unto them. And when the vision was shown, whatever it was, they wrote it down. Alright. So it says, and the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables. So they ought to make it plain upon that table. Know the vision plane, alright? And then it says that he may run that readeth it, alright? So whoever reads that vision on that table will be able to run, alright? And basically what it means by run is it's talking about having an understanding of when these that vision comes to pass, what to do. Alright? Verse 3, for the vision is yet for an appointed time, by the end it shall speak, alright, and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come, it will not tarry. Alright, so basically the Lord was saying that, you know, let me read it again.
He said, but the vision is yet for an appointed time.
Yeah, the vision that was written down was for an appointed time. There was a time where that vision would come to pass. And guess what, we're in the midst of this vision that's being spoken of here. Alright, so it says, but in the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, for it shall surely come, it will not tarry. Alright, and that's the thing that's happening right now. All these things that's happening with the vid, alright? The famines you're hearing about, that's what's spoken in the Bible.
build upon that. It's the book of Jeremiah 28 and 8. And it says, the prophets that have been before me and before the old prophesied both against many countries and against many kingdoms, all right, of war and of evil and of pestilence, all right. And this is one of those kingdoms of war, evil, and pestilence that basically the Heavenly Father would, hey, like he's always done in times past, he basically raised up a prophet, right, this being the last key heathen rulership, right, the time of the wicked, basically, he's going to raise prophets to prophesy against his kingdom, all right. So let me run that back. So it says, the prophets that have been before me and before the evolved prophesied both against many countries and against great kingdoms, war, evil, and pestilence. Alright? So that's what the prophets did in times past. And this kingdom ain't night different. Alright, in that sense, because it's the same as before. Let me read book of 2nd Esdras 9 and 1. It says, he answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself, and when thou seest part of the signs pass, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it's the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made. Right? So you know me, I got a habit for running these things back, man. So let me run it back. So he answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently. All right? How you meant to measure the time? You meant to measure it by way of the scriptures. All right? And let me prove that point very quickly.
Not only is he a good guy, he's super, super
man. It's a lucky man. Right now. Right, so this is Matthew 24 and 42. It says, watch therefore, for ye know not the hour the Lord doth come, but know this, that if the good man of the house knoweth in what watch the thief would come, he would have watched and would not have suffered his house to be broken up. Therefore be ye always ready, for in such an hour as you think, if not, the Son of Man cometh. Alright? So basically, we're meant to watch, alright? But the scripture I was looking for was watch as well as pray. I'm rusty with this offhand pulling scripture. But it says, I'll
go back to 2nd Esdras 9 and 1. It says, he answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself. And when thou seest part of the signs pass, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made.
Alright? So basically we're to measure the time, and the way we measure the time is by going into the word. Right?
Because the measurement of the time is the heavenly Father, Yahweh Shai, put forth signs, alright, of his coming. Right? I should have just read that. Keep it simple.
signs that he put forth is basically to let you know that he's on his way. So when you see the signs coming, then you would know he's on the way. All right. That's why I was instructed to measure the time diligently. So it says, this is Matthew 24:1. It says, and Yahushua went out and departed from the temple, and his disciples came to him for to show him the buildings of the temple. And Yahushua said unto them, see ye not all these things? Verily I say unto you, there shall not be left there one stone upon another.
Right.
Verily I say unto you, there shall not be left one stone upon another that shall not be thrown down. Alright. So he's basically prophesying that the temple back then would be thrown down, basically. Alright. And it was. Alright. That's why you have now the ruins and what the so-called Jew calls today the Wailing Wall. Alright. So reading on, it says, and as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying, tell us, when shall these things be, and what shall be the sign of thy coming and the end of the world? All right? Because they basically knew that Yahushua's appearing on the earth at that time indicated one thing and one thing alone. All right? That they were in the times of the end. Because the books prophesied of when he came, how basically he'd usher in the kingdom of heaven. All right? So they wanted to know what sign they'd have to look for in order to know for his coming. All right? And it goes through a myriad of them, right? But I want to dwell on the point of prophecy, the importance of it, all right? So let me grab one more scripture around this. And it's the key scripture as well. It's Revelation 19. Revelation 19 and 10, it says, and I fell at his feet to worship him, and he said unto me, see thou do it not, I am thy fellow servant and of thy brethren that have the testimony of Yahushua. Worship the Most High, for the testimony of Yahushua is the spirit of prophecy. All right, the spirit of prophecy, basically the testimony of the Heavenly Father's Son, Yahushua, who the world knows as Jesus Christ, is basically the spirit of prophecy, all right? And what is prophecy? Prophecy means to say before, when you break down the word. Pro meaning before, and phasai meaning to say. So basically, the spirit of the Heavenly Father's Son is to say things that are going to happen before. And when they come to pass, that's the fulfillment of his testimony. That's foolproof of his doctrine, all right? So now let's get into some current affairs, because right now, we're in the midst of a lockdown, 2021, all right? With this pandemic that's going on with the vid, all right? And you have Boris Johnson basically come out and say that this, from what the scientists are telling him, that this strain of COVID is more severe than the previous ones, all right?